guys, welcome back to my channel. So it is almost lunchtime and I am sharing what I eat in a day, but I thought I would pop on here to let you know that today is a little bit special. I'm not making only my recipes, I am making some recipes from my friend Michelle's cookbook called Eating Whole. So I discovered Michelle quite a while ago, maybe even before I started my YouTube channel. She has been vegan for over 12 years, has had two healthy vegan pregnancies, shares her home birth stories on her YouTube channel. She has cookbooks, vegan weight loss courses, personal coaching sessions. So she is just a plethora of knowledge, tons of delicious recipes. So I was really excited to do a little collaboration with her. I'm gonna be making some recipes from her Eating Whole cookbook. She has over 70 plant-based recipes in that book, all that are refined sugar, flour, oil-free. So if you're interested in kind of an SOS diet, should definitely check out her book. So it's almost lunchtime, but this morning I had some steel-cut oats with caramelized banana from her book, and it was so good. I love bananas, and I never think to spend a little extra time to caramelize them. It took no time at all, but it made breakfast super fancy. So let me show you how I made that. So I'm guessing a ton of you guys are familiar with steel-cut oats, but probably don't buy them because they take forever to cook, so I'm going to show you an awesome, quick and easy way to meal prep them the night before you want them. And you basically just need 5 minutes of hands-on time, and then they're ready when you wake up. So in this pot, I put 1 cup of oats, 2 cups of water, 2 cups of almond milk, and I'm bringing everything to a boil. And once it's boiling, I'm just gonna let it boil for about a minute before I cover the pot, remove it from the heat, and then you're just gonna let it sit out on the counter overnight. And when you wake up, you've got fully cooked, creamy, chewy, nutty steel-cut oats that are ready to go. So you could make a big pot of this and have it all week long and just change up the toppings. I had this with protein powder sometimes, but today I wanted to make Michelle's caramelized bananas, and this was so easy. I just heated a pan over medium-high heat. I added a little bit of oil just to double check that these wouldn't stick to the pan, and then I just put them cut side down into the oil, let them fry for a little bit until they got golden and caramelized, and then flip them over, let them cook on the other side as well before adding them to my oats. So this is a super fun and easy way to jazz up your oatmeal toppings if you don't have a lot of time or just bored with your normal toppings. Definitely try this out. You could top them with some sea salt, some cinnamon. It was delicious. So for the oats, when you are ready to eat them, you can reheat them in the same pot. I added in some ground flaxseed, some cinnamon, just for the base to have a little more oomph. And then I just poured this into a bowl with the caramelized banana. And of course I had to add my peanut butter. And then I added some sunflower seeds for crunch. And this was a super delicious, hearty way to start my day. We enjoyed this for a couple of days. We would just add different toppings. My kids loved it with a berry compote I made the other day. My husband always does banana and peanut butter just like me. So this was super delicious. Highly recommend trying this recipe out from Michelle's cookbook. And for an afternoon snack, I whipped up a little mocha here. I have a super simple chocolate syrup recipe on my blog that I love to have in the fridge just to either make mochas or chocolate milk for my kids. It's just a fun summer thing to have on hand to create a little bit more of a special drink on these hot summer days.
So if you would have watched my most recent What I Eat in a Week video, you would have seen that I enjoy a coffee every day. Usually start with it black and end up turning it into a latte, but lately I've been making my black coffee and putting it straight into the fridge or freezer to chill. And then I like to make this chocolate syrup to have on hand to make iced mocha. So it's just coconut sugar, cocoa powder, and hot water, and you're just gonna whisk that. You don't even have to do it over heat, but you're gonna whisk that until smooth, and then you just store this in the fridge, and you can add it to sundaes, milk for chocolate milk, or in my case, I like to make iced mochas.
First, icing coffee. My mocha. What do you think? Is it okay? Now it is lunchtime and we had some friends over last night and my friend made me, oh, one of my favorite things in the world, a fresh loaf of sourdough. So we're gonna cut that up, toast it, and have it with some leftover red lentil curry. So that should be delicious.
So I just want to mention that there is no one way to eat a plant-based diet. I am cooking from Michelle's cookbook, which is all about whole foods, excluding refined sugars and flours and oil, and I am still eating this freshly made white sourdough bread that my friend made me because that's okay for me in this season of life as I'm nursing and need a ton of energy and have a hard time maintaining a healthy weight. So just know that you can tweak people's cookbooks or recipes to suit your health goals, and there are multiple ways to eat a plant-based diet, so hopefully that is a helpful thing to remind you of.
And for dinner, I made another one of Vegan Michelle's recipes from her cookbook for plum tofu.
So as soon as I saw this recipe, I knew I wanted to make it because it reminds me of the sweet and sour tofu I've been making recently, but with a different flavor profile, more sweet of a sauce. And so I started by pressing my tofu and then whipping up the plum sauce, which had garlic, ginger, soy sauce, rice vinegar, maple syrup, tomato paste, and cornstarch in it. And it was really easy to make, used mostly pantry staple ingredients. So I just whisked that together and set it aside. And once my tofu had been pressed, I cut it into cubes. I ended up using 2 blocks of tofu for the plum sauce. I just felt like it would be a better ratio for me, and it turned out so perfectly in my opinion and gave us leftovers, which as a busy mom, you know how much I appreciate some leftovers. So I just put the cubed tofu in a marinade of soy sauce, cornstarch, and rice vinegar, plopped this on a baking sheet, and then baked these in the oven until crispy. While the tofu was baking, I also whipped up some of my favorite crispy kale chips. This is so easy to make and takes about 10 minutes in the oven. It's so simple and a great way to eat your greens. So I just ripped some kale leaves off of the stem, dried them till they were completely dry, drizzled them with just a teeny bit of olive oil, and then you're gonna use your hands to massage that oil all onto the leaves. Add a little garlic salt or any spices you want, spread them out, and plop them in the oven. I also whipped up some quinoa, and my favorite way to cook quinoa is 1 part quinoa to 2 parts water. You're gonna bring it all to a boil and let it cook at a simmer until all the water is evaporated. And that's when you're gonna cover it, remove it from the heat, and allow it to sit for about 5 minutes until nice and fluffy. Now to finish off the tofu, I just poured that plum sauce into a saucepan, added in my crispy tofu, and then the cornstarch in the tofu and also in the sauce is gonna thicken as you heat it. And this became super sweet and sticky, and my husband said it tasted like pei wei, which is a huge compliment. We loved this. It was so flavorful, tasted great with that fluffy, kind of basic quinoa and the salty, crunchy kale chips. This was just such a good meal. I could eat this every day without any complaints, so I definitely recommend you guys try it out.
I really love this sauce.
And of course, because I barely had any chocolate today, I ended the night with a big square of dark chocolate and some tea.
So if you guys are looking for more people to follow to help you be inspired in the kitchen with more recipes, be sure to check out Vegan Michelle. I'll link everything you need to follow her journey, her YouTube channel, her cookbooks, to get in contact with her down in the description box. Michelle's also filming a What I Eat in a Day video today, so after you watch my video, be sure to go check hers out. She's going to be making a couple recipes from my plant-biased book, so that should be exciting. But be sure to check her out, leave a comment on her video letting her know that I sent you, and I will see you guys in the video very soon. Bye.